Hey, what's up? My name is Mizmi, and today I'm going to be explaining the best attachment setups to be using on the AK-74U in Cold War multiplayer. These setups that I'm about to show you are what all of the professional players use on their streams, whether it's Scump, Dashy, Simp, Apathy, you name it, they all use this class setup on the AK-74U. And of course, this is one of the most used weapons in the Call of Duty Pro League, where they're competing for hundreds of thousands of dollars. Do you think they would use anything less than the best attachment setups? Spoiler alert, the answer is no. So that's why I'm here today, to show you the attachments they use and the reasoning behind what makes them the best attachments to be using on the AK-74U. Oh my god, this gun. Oh my goodness, this gun is ridiculous. So we're going to be starting off with the regular multiplayer setup, but feel free to use the timestamps in the description below if you're interested in just a certain part of the video. Don't forget, if this video helps you out, leave a like or a comment letting me know that you enjoyed it. Speaking of which, it's been an absolutely insane week for this channel. We passed the 500 subscriber milestone, which is absolutely huge, and I promised something special when we hit that goal, and I'll be announcing this in my next episode of RNG Camo Mastery, which goes live on this Sunday. So make sure you're subscribed and you've got those notifications on so that you don't miss it. Anyway, it's time to turn this beautiful weapon into a monster. So this is the general class setup that I use on the AK-74U. Most of it is down to personal preference, but I would say some of the best in slot things to be using here are the Stim Shot, the Field Mic, Ninja, and Ghost. Other than that, you can use whatever you want, but we are here for the attachments, so let's get talking. On the AK-74U, I don't like to use an optic. I think the iron sights as they are beautiful. You get such a clear vision, you don't have a massive gun blocking your screen, so you just don't need a red dot, honestly. So we skip the optic and we go onto the muzzle. So on the muzzle, there are two main attachments you can use. I'll start with one that I will use, then I'll explain the other option afterwards. So the best option for Cold War multiplayer is Spetsnaz Compensator. This gives you 12% vertical recoil control at the cost of 8% horizontal recoil control. This attachment is absolutely fantastic for the muzzle slot. The vertical recoil control you get from this is so big. It basically means this gun turns into a beam, your bullets are firing in a perfectly straight line, and you don't really need to do much recoil control at all when you're using this attachment. It's so good. This makes the recoil on this gun a lot more consistent for basically all ranges. You can absolutely take fights that are 50 meters plus, which is quite a considerable distance for an SMG. And once you get used to it, you can be beating those players using the assault rifles. So just because this is an SMG does not mean you're bad at long range when you put this attachment on. The other option for the muzzle is the groove suppressor. I've seen some people using it and I tried it myself. It's pretty good, it's pretty strong. But I find that minus 25% effective damage range is quite a bit. It reduces your effective damage range from 7.62 meters down to 5.72 meters, which, sure, it's not a huge difference, but realistically, that is actually quite considerable when you look at it. So it is quite a big con, but it takes you off the map. It gives you 7% vertical recoil control, which is really nice. If you're a player who likes to rush around the back of enemies, kind of playing that stealthy flanking role, then this is probably the attachment for you, because getting yourself off that minimap is really, really nice. But if you're a player who just likes to get in their face, get on the objective and hold it down, you don't care if enemies know where you are because you're on the objective, then the Spetsnaz Compensator is the one that you want to be using in the muzzle slot. So next up, we move on to the barrel. It's just a very simple attachment. It's the 9.3 inch extended barrel. What this does is it gives you 40% increased bullet velocity. If you don't know this already, bullet velocity on Cold War is an absolutely massive stat, especially on the SMGs. What it basically means is how quickly your bullet will get from your gun to the opponent. So increasing that by 40%, which is quite a respectable amount for no cons whatsoever, is a fantastic, fantastic attachment. I have seen some people go for the 10.3 inch Liberator barrel, but I found that that minus 25% walking speed is just not worth the extra bullet velocity. When you're playing as an SMG player, you want to be really mobile and sprinting around the map, surprising enemies, being able to strafe whilst you're aiming really quick left to right to throw their bullets off. And by losing 25% of that aim walking speed is just, it's just too much in my opinion. So that's why I like to go for the 9.3 inch extended. We don't bother with the barrel on this gun. All they do is really give you a reveal distance, which I don't think is that great. Or they give you hip fire accuracy, which, I mean, sure, that's kind of nice, but it's nowhere near as good as some of the other attachments. So we skip over that. Straight onto the underbarrel, where we will be using the Spetsnaz Speed Grip. Now, this is an attachment I actually only recently started using, and oh my god, it's so good. I used to be a fanboy of the Spetsnaz grip because, I mean, look at those stats, 6% vertical recoil and 20% horizontal. Those are pretty insane. But you lose 30% shooting move speed, which I just thought, you know what, it's probably worth it for the recoil. But since I've been using this Spetsnaz Speed Grip, it has changed my game. I'm not even exaggerating. The main draw to this attachment is that 10% sprinting move speed. oh my god, you can tell the difference so much. You absolutely fly around the map. You're so quick getting to those objectives, making those rush routes, whether you're playing Search and Destroy or anything else, and you get 15% horizontal recoil on top of that, which is absolutely insane. So I honestly think I'm going to be using this attachment on any SMG that I run from now on, apart from maybe the Mac 10, because the recoil on that is absolutely wild. This may well be my new favorite attachment. And the next attachment you want to be using in Cold War multiplayer is the magazine, the Gru Mag Clamp. Now this attachment, I absolutely love it. You get 40% increased reload quickness, which is huge. Like, your reload is practically instant. It's insane. And you gain an extra magazine for your life, which is fantastic. It basically means you don't need scavenger at all, which I don't think you even really need it anyway, but you never run out of ammo when you're using this attachment. And at the cost of only 6% aim down sight time, like, that is an absolute no-brainer to me. This SMG does only come with 30 rounds in a magazine by default though, so I completely understand that if you want more ammo, and probably for Warzone as well, you want to use this, you want to go for the VDV 50 round fast mag. So this obviously gives you 50 rounds in a magazine, gives you 40% reload quickness as well, which is really, really nice, but it does come at quite a big cost of minus 25% aim down sight time. For me personally, I really like having high aim down sight time so you can make those really quick snap plays, but if you're a more reserved player, you're not rushing around the map like an absolute maniac, then maybe the 50 round fast mag is for you. But personally, I love the Gru Mag Clamp on this gun. And now the final attachment for regulation multiplayer is the Gru Elastic Wrap. I mean, this is a favorite for pretty much every gun in the game. I don't know how it's not been nerfed or anything, because quite frankly, it is ridiculous. It gives you 30% aim down sight time, which on its own is really good. It gives you 90% flinch resistance, so when you're getting shot, your screen's not flying all over the place, you're just staying laser focused on your target. And you can drop shot with this attachment. Like, what were they thinking? The cons are only minus 10% shooting move speed, which, sure, that's kind of big, but not huge. And minus 15% sprint to fire time. It's ridiculous. This attachment is just a must have on pretty much any gun at the minute. So because of that, we're just going to put it straight on, because it is just such a ridiculously good attachment. So let's see what the final multiplayer build is for this weapon. Absolutely beautiful. For some reason, it takes your camo off when you inspect it, but you can see the attachments here nicely laid out for you. You will absolutely be dominating your lobbies when you're using this. It's just a ridiculous weapon. There is no doubt this is the best SMG in Cold War, and there's a reason why pretty much all of the pros use this weapon in the Call of Duty League. And seeing as we're here talking about what the pros use in the Call of Duty League, let's head over to League Play, where there's loads of different restrictions that all the pros follow in Call of Duty League, at least for the most part, and I'll show you what the best attachments are for this meta weapon in League Play. Spawn behind. Right, let's get the next one now, they're not on it. Nice. GG's, Lance. Okay, so let's jump right into League Play. We'll get the class setup going and I'll talk you through it. So this is my AK-74U class that I like to run on League Play. I honestly think these are the best attachments you can be running. The Search and Destroy class is slightly different. You basically swap out Perk Greed for Lawbreaker, you get rid of that Diamati, and you put on the Tundra or the Pellington, whatever sniper you want to use, and that's probably one of the best Search and Destroy classes there is. But we're just going to be focusing on the AK-74U this video, so we'll keep Perk Greed on and just talk about the attachments you should be using for that. So this setup that I'm about to show you is what Scumpy and most of the other Call of Duty pros have been using this weekend at the recent CDL Major, so you know that by putting these attachments on, you will have the best chance possible against your opponents in League Play. So starting with the muzzle, counter to what we do in multiplayer, we actually go for the Muzzle Break 5.45. So the reason Scump likes to use this attachment is just because it gives you that vertical recoil control for no cons. Anywhere you can get a nice pro for limited or no cons, you absolutely take it, because you want every advantage you can have. So put on the Muzzle Break 5.45 on the muzzle. On the barrel here, again, we're going for the 9.3 inch extended. Like I said, you get a pretty nice pro here, 40% bullet velocity and no cons, making it an absolutely solid attachment. Again, there is some argument to be using that 10.3 inch Liberator, but the pros really, really like their movement speed and mobility in Cold War. So having that extra bullet velocity is pretty much unnecessary and comes with a con, therefore we go for the 9.3 inch. On the underbarrel, like I said, it's an attachment that's relatively new to me, and oh my god, it's just the best attachment, no brainer. Spetsnaz speed grip, getting that sprinting move speed is huge, especially in League Play where you will be focusing on the objective. If you're not playing the objective in League Play, then you shouldn't be playing League Play, but being able to rotate around the map or get back into the fight after you've respawned is absolutely crucial, therefore having that extra move speed is just ridiculously good. So on goes the Spetsnaz speed grip. Now the pros don't actually like to use any sort of magazine in the CDL. Some do go for slightly extended magazines, but on the SMGs they generally tend not to. And this is not only because they want both a handle and a stock attachment, but in League play and the Call of Duty Pro League, the team size is 4v4. Now this means the pace of the game can be a bit slower, and you just don't need 50 rounds in your magazine. You're not going to be killing like 6 people in one clip. You're lucky if you kill 2 people in one clip on League play, because the skill level is just that much higher. You're not living for as long. People are trading out their teammates when they die, so it's not all that often that you're able to make use of those extended mags or the extra reload speed. So the pros don't like to use a magazine, which means we move on to the handle. And like I said before, the Gru Elastic Wrap is just ridiculous. It does what it says on the tin: massively increased aim down sight speed, 90% flinch resistance, and being able to drop shot. It's just a ridiculous attachment. I reckon the cons could be double what they are and it would still be OP, so we're just going to put it on. And finally, the stock. Now the pros really like the KGB skeletal stock. Yes, it does come with minus 30% hipfire accuracy, which is pretty huge, but realistically you don't actually hit fire that much in COD. Most of the time it is a last resort if someone has surprised you or they come around a corner and just get up in your face. So if someone's that close to you, you don't really need that much hip fire accuracy anyway, because they are literally 1 or 2 meters away from you. So losing that's not a huge deal, especially when you're gaining 30% sprint to fire time and 10% aim walking move speed. This just allows you to peek around those corners whilst aiming down sight much easier. And as you're sprinting around the map with that extra mobility that the Spetsnaz speed grip gives you, being able to stop sprinting and shoot your enemies nice and quick is just a really nice pro to have. So on goes the KGB skeletal stock. So we'll just get a quick inspect up for what the final gun looks like for League play, and here you go. A few of the attachments are the same as regular multiplayer, but obviously with the restrictions and the way that the pros play, you do want a slightly different gun setup compared to just public matches on multiplayer. So absolutely give these attachments a go, and trust me, you'll be blown away by it. When I put these on, I was just dominating every single lobby I was in. It's just insane. It's such a good weapon. It's so much fun to use. Give these attachments a go. Let me know how you find it in the comments. Give this video a like if it's helped you. And of course, feel free to check out my channel for my other content. Drop a subscribe if you like what you see. And hopefully I'll see you on my next video, which will be a new episode of RNG Camo Mastery, my Road to Dark Matter series with a twist. And it's going to be a particularly special episode with a huge announcement. So make sure you're there. I'll see you then.